Good afternoon, dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Today, we are gathered in the celebration of the Holy Eucharist. Our Eucharistic celebration will be presided over by His Excellency, Most Reverend John F. Du D.D., Archbishop of Palau. Let us now be one mind and heart in worship and join our voices in song as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
Of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you.
And
And so, my dear brothers and sisters, we are very grateful, thankful to the Lord for this 23rd National Quirinal Convention. And we are very thankful to you to come on this occasion. And we are very sad that our bishop, chairman of this commission, has just died 3 days ago. So we pray for his repose as we pray for all of you, for our lay people who have been very active in the church. We pray for peace, we pray for unity, and we pray for the synod that has been going on in Vatican. And so we humble ourselves before God, asking forgiveness for whatever failures we have done. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever-Virgin, and all the angels and the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Sincerity of heart, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I know that good does not dwell in me, that is, in my flesh. The willing is ready at hand, but doing the good is not. For I do not do the good I want, but I do the evil I do not want. Now if I do what I do not want, it is no longer I who do it, but sin that dwells in me. So then I discovered the principle that when I want to do right, evil is at hand. For I take delight in the law of God, in my inner self. But I see in my members another principle at war with the law of my mind, taking me captive to the law of sin that dwells in my members. Miserable one that I am, who will deliver me from this mortal body? Thanks be to God, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Statues, Lord, teach me your statues. Lord, teach me your statues. Lord, teach me your statues. Teach me wisdom and knowledge, for in your commands I trust. Lord, teach me your statutes. Lord, teach me your statutes. Statutes, Lord, teach me your statutes. Let your kindness comfort me according to your promise to your servants. Lord, teach me statutes. Lord, teach me your statutes. Let your compassion come to me that I may live, for your law is my delight. Lord, teach me statutes. Lord, teach me your statutes. Never will I forget your precepts, for through them you give me life. Lord, teach me statutes. Lord, teach me your statutes. I am yours, save me, for I have sought your precepts. Teach me your statutes, Lord, teach me your statutes. Lord, teach me your statutes, Lord, teach me
all.
All please stand.
Jesus said to the crowds, "When you see a cloud rising in the west, you say immediately that it is going to rain, and so it does. And when you notice that the wind is blowing from the south, you say that it is going to be hot, and so it is. You hypocrites, you know how to interpret the appearance of the earth and the sky. Why do you not know how to interpret the present time? Why do you not judge for yourselves what is right? If you are to go with your opponent before a magistrate, make an effort to settle the matter on the way. Otherwise, your opponent will turn over to the judge, and the judge hand you over to the constable, and the constable throw you into prison. I say to you, you will not be released until you pay the last penny."
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
First of all, in behalf of the clergy of the Diocese of Palok, especially our Vicar General Monsignor Gilbert Ordina and our Rector of the Cathedral, Reverend Father Rodolfo Baro, and of course our very own chaplain of the Laico, Reverend Father Paulino Cabahit, the religious, the seminarians are also with me, with us right now, and the Laico. I would like to welcome all of you, delegates of the 23rd Laico National Vineyard Convention. We are very happy of your coming, of your presence, but we're very sad that our commission bishop, chairman, Bishop Enrique Macaraig, died. And so let's pray for his repose. May God give him eternal rest in peace. I would like also to acknowledge the officers, the national officers of our LICO. And of course, we are very happy that Raymond Daniel Cross arrived the other day, but now he is admitted in the hospital. We pray for his recovery. Then we have also Albert Lotero, Executive Vice President. Then Gertrude Bautista, the Vice President for Ecclesiastical Province of Manila. Armin Ibarra, the Vice President for Luzon. Dr. Rene Joseph Bolicer, the Vice President for Visayas. The Vice President for Mindanao, Procolo Sarmen. The Treasurer, Conchita de la Cruz. The Auditor, Fatima Estacio. And of course, our very own, I would say, Head of the LICO Archdiocese of Palo, Dr. Edna Yaso. And all of you, my dear brothers and sisters, participants, we hope that in this couple of days, you're going to really enrich yourself and become inspired to serve the church as we go on with our convention. In today's gospel, my dear brothers and sisters, our Lord wants us to understand the signs of the present time, to live the present moment. No doubt that the word we have now is quite different from the word before. There is advancement of technology that has greatly affected our way of life. Many things have changed in the past decades. These concerns are not just for the secular world, but also for our church, for we live in the same world. And so, the church has to know, the church has to listen to the situation of our life now. Very challenging. For this reason, currently in Rome, the bishop, together with the lay people representing all the faithful around the world, are having a month-long synod on synodality. This reminds us that the church has to hear, to listen, not just for the ordained, but most especially you, our dear lay people. The church is not just an organization full of principle, but of a community of acceptance and love. The Synod of Synodality is happening because we are answering to our responsibility of taking care of each other, because God has entrusted to us the care of the other and to build His kingdom of love and peace, especially in this time when wars are really going on. There's so much trouble in the world that we are living, like the war in Israel, in Ukraine, and many others. All of these form, we are challenged to our mission. Amidst of all these changes in society, one of the things that remain constant is our mission. Our mission of bringing Christ to others. My dear brothers and sisters, as Christians, we are bearer of God and we are to bring God to others. We are able to bring God to others when we take good care of others and do good to them. We cannot be indifferent of the needs of others. Solidarity is caring for others, and each one of us should not be indifferent, but get involved to be engaged of what is going on in the world that we are living. My dear brothers and sisters, we should never forget our Blessed Mother. Our Blessed Mother is a model in our mission. The first thing that Mary did after receiving the great task of being the Mother of God was to take care of her cousin Elizabeth. She went in haste to take care of her pregnant and elderly cousin. My dear brothers and sisters, we should never be independent. We should be mindful of the others, especially for those who are in need, especially for places that are in trouble right now. For our brothers and sisters who are in need, that's our mission. That's why we have to unite ourselves. We have to join our effort so we could be of help, not just in small scale, but in a bigger scale. We are part of one family, family of God, with Christ as our head. Mary would always tell us, do whatever it tells you. It therefore follows that the mission of Christ is our mission too, whether you are religious or a lay person. We are part of the church that Christ has instituted. The church is not just the property of the Pope, the bishops, or the priests. Each one of us has to do his part, for we have all received a role to play. And its role is important to the life and to the building of the church. Our role, your role as lay faithful, is not secondary to the role of the priests, of the bishops, the religious. Your role as a faithful is vital to the life in the church for love and peace to reign in our community. Recognize saints in the Philippines were lay faithful, St. Lorenzo Ruiz and St. Pedro Calungsod. They are lay. They serve as a Christian, catechist, and lay missionaries. We are calling you, our dear lay people, to be our partner, to be always one with us, and to exert our effort so that we could really bring the love and the peace that our Lord would like to establish in this earth. Your role as a mother and as a father is a very important role. Your life in the family is important in the evangelization of the new generation. Your work, ang trabaho mo, should be used in serving others and never mingle it with by yourself, to be just being selfish and not being mindful, and engage yourself in whatever wrong, whatever you want in life. Consider our brothers and sisters who are in need, who are suffering, brothers and sisters who are sick, brothers and sisters who are in trouble, brothers and sisters who need to be listened. The most concrete way of serving others is by doing well our work, our role in life. Pope Francis invites us to live in synodality. And synodality is putting our gifts at the service of others. We become a channel of God's love to others. We become a gift to others. We become a gift to others whenever we do well the role that God has given to us. That's why we have to unite, not to compete, not to let others consider as somebody secondary. Each one of us is important. And so as we continue with this holy sacrifice of the Mass, as we open this convention, we ask our Blessed Mother, our model, who is really doing his role, our mother who is going to help us to become good stewards. She was not ordained. She has a great role in our salvation. She took good care of our Lord in her womb and was able to bring the Lord to others. She stood by our Lord, both in good and in bad times, a loyal steward. Let us ask the Blessed Mother that we could also have the courage to stand like her at the cross, facing all the challenges, but trusting that God will always be on our side. We can only be united if we learn to listen, to take care of others, and by doing our own roles faithfully, we become united in our mission of bringing others to others. Once again, I welcome all of you, and I would like also to welcome our dear Reverend Fathers who are here accompanying their lay, Monsignor Alex Ramon Amante, Dice of San Pablo, Laguna, Father Melchor of Palomeras, Dice of Lawag, Father Rostom Dirain from Dice of Gumaca, Father Anthony Adawan, Dice of Bayumbong, and Father Felicito Boris, SBD, LVD, and of course, Father Vic Hapson from the Dice of Nabal. And to all of you, I wish you all the joy of being together, the joy of listening to each other, the joy that God is with us, the gospel of love may be experienced in our this convention. May this gathering help us to become more effective, good and loyal steward of God, bearer of good news and peace and love. God bless us all. Amen. So as all, we are happy. We give a big round of applause to everyone who is here.
All please stand.
Lord Jesus tells us to watch for the day of his return. Let us come to the Father in prayer, watching and waiting for the Lord's return. For every petition, we say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. That the church may respond to the call for conversion and renewal, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That people of goodwill may work together to put an end to war and hatred, oppression and injustice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may become more aware of the presence of Christ among the poor and the suffering people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may be given strength and hope, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our friends and relatives who have died may experience everlasting joy in the company of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions.
Lord, Almighty God, listen to our prayers. Open our eyes to your presence all around us. Make us closer to you each day. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Let us all be seated for the liturgy of the Eucharist, and we'll have our offertory procession.
Hanggaran mo, tuyo ka'y kinabuhin.
And sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, Lord, we pray, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love. His resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and the saints, we praise you as without end, we acclaim. Gifts we pray by sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may gather into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
O may evil grace may grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy may always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
Sins, but in the faith of your church, and gracefully grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Now let's show each other the sign of peace. Peace to you all. To the banquet of our Lord. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. The body and blood of Christ bring me to life everlasting. Amen.
All please stand.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that benefiting from participation in heavenly things, may we be helped by what you give in this present age, and prepared for the gifts that are eternal, through Christ our Lord.
Be seated. Good evening, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ.
So, first and foremost, let's thank the Lord for this gathering, for the safe travel of everybody who's here. So, and so we continue to pray for the success of this 23rd Biennial, National Biennial Convention of the Sangguniang Laykunang Pilipinas. So, it gives me great pleasure to be among the 300 participants or so to this 23rd Biennial Convention of the Council of the Laity of the Philippines. And so for this year, hosted by the Archdiocese of Palo. So we thank Archbishop Jandu and of course all the clergy, our Vicar General, and of course our spiritual director, and all the clergy and all the laity are here in the Archdiocese of Palo for all the support with the preparation for this very momentous event. So thank you very much, Archdiocese of Palo. So this convention, yes. And of course, thank you very much to all of you who accepted the invitation to come here despite the despite all the uncertainties, all the mishappenings around us, should I say, not only for our country but also for the world, as mentioned by Archbishop Du. So this convention is therefore a very opportune time for us to come to work together and be united in mission as a synodal church. So we can better work together if we know each other. So let me present the officers and movers who brought this event to fruition, the speakers and participants to this convention. We actually have 28 national lay organizations and 37 diocesan councils of the laity who are here with us now. So as if you are able, as I call your name or your group, please stand to be acknowledged. So first and foremost, of course, the officers and staff of the Sangguniang Laykunang Pilipinas. Of course, so please stand. The incumbent officers and members of the Sangguniang Laykunang Pilipinas. Of course, we pray for the national president, Father Raymond Daniel Cruz, who is now admitted in our local hospital. So we continue to pray for him for his fast recovery. So, of course, I'd like to special mention Mr. Albert Lutero, the overall chair for this convention, and he's actually the vice president of the Sangguniang Laiko, executive vice president, and he comes from Leyte. So anyway, for tomorrow, so we will actually be introducing during the opening ceremony all the officers of the Sangguniang Laiko ng Pilipinas, the Laiko Board of Directors 2022. So I will be presenting the participants later, or would you like here or there during the welcome here now? So I will present the participants by group. I call your name, kindly stand. So for the 28 national lay organizations, we have the CWL. Where are you now? So CWL, then the Mother Butlers Guild, the Federation of Transparochial Charismatic Communities. Are you here now? Ang Ligaya ng Panginoon. The Holy Name Society of the Philippines. The Lord's Flock Catholic Charismatic Community. The Theresian Association. The Carmelites Missionary Secular. The Catholic Teachers Guild of the Philippines. The Missionary Families of Christ. The Focolare Movement. Responsible Parenthood All Natural Family Planning Method Network. Christ Family Mission Movement. Bukas Loob sa Diyos Covenant Community. St. John Apostle and Evangelist Services Association. World Apostolate of Fatima. Corsilios de Cristianidad. Society of St. Vincent de Paul, Legion of Mary, Couples for Christ, the Brotherhood of Christian Businessmen and Professionals, the Familia Community Foundation, the Children of God, the Father Apostolate, Federation of Free Farmers, Barangay San Virgen, the Knights of Columbus, and the Association of Augustinian Sisters of Our Lady of Consolacion, and the Crusaders of the Holy Face of Jesus. The representation by regions from the ecclesiastical province of Manila, we have from Imus, Diocese of Imus, Diocese of Caloocan, please stand, Diocese of Malolos, Archdiocese of Manila, from Novaliches, from Paranaque, from Pasig, from San Pablo, from Taytay, Palawan. So from Luzon, we have from Alaminos, from Baguio, from Bayumbong, Nueva Vizcaya, from Calapan, from Daet, from Gumaca, Lawag, Ligaspe, Lingayen Dagupan, San Fernando Pampanga, San Jose Nueva Ecija, Sorsogon, from Tarlac. I'll start with Mindanao first before Visayas because we... So from Mindanao, Cagayan de Oro, from Malaybalay, Surigao, Antago, for the Visayas, Anteque, Bacolod, Catarman, Cebu, Haro, Maasin, Navang, Romblon, Tagbilaran, Talibon Bohol, and of course, the host diocese, the Archdiocese of Palo, please all stand, including the PPC-PFC from the Metropolitan Cathedral of Palo, who are our host this tonight for the welcome dinner. So thank you very much. So and welcome everyone, and let's have a good night tonight. God bless us all. Of course, I just introduced the laico, but let us give a hand to our clergy. Thank you very much for the support to the laity. Thank you, Archbishop Du, for all the support to the laico. We are praying for all of you. All please stand.
Thank you very much, Dr. Edna Yaso. She's working very hard together with Father Paul and the committee. Thank you very much for your effort and dedication. I just would like to inform you that we are now in this cathedral that has been totally destroyed by Yolanda. There was no roof, there was no ceiling, everything has been blown. We are now on our 10th year of Yolanda. This coming November 8th, that will be the 10th year. And here we are recovered as if nothing happened. But I would like to thank you, Laico ng Pilipinas, because you are helping us in one way or another, whatever assistance you have given from your diocese and archdiocese, and that donation were able to recover our churches, our convents, and almost everything. So 10 years, we recovered everything with your help. Thank you very much. Salve. O Holy Mother of God, eternal rest grant to Bishop Enrique Macaray, O Lord. May rest in peace. Just to tell you, before this event, I met Bishop Enrique, and he was telling me, Archbishop Jando, how is the preparation? I said, okay, everything is okay. He said, baka hindi ako makapunta doon. Why? He's telling me, very busy ako dama ako. There's, I have so many things to do. Maybe I'll come on the last day. I said, you have to come on the last day. He said, I'll try. Pero talagang may doubts na siya to come here. So, because he died. So, let's pray. And also, let's pray for our president. He will also recover. He had a chest pain when he arrived here yesterday. So let's pray for one another. We have to pray very hard, you know, because time is very challenging this time. So many things that we have to pray our concerns. So I hope that this gathering will be a very meaningful, fruitful one, because we have so many concerns in our time, in the Philippines. And we have election this coming October 30. And many things. So let's pray for one another. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Made heaven and earth.
And may the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
This time, we're going to have a group pictorial with our Archbishop John, together with the Consellar Brothers. Yung half of the folks, manatili muna kayong makaupo. We request yung nasa likod to please come forward. We request the ushers and usherettes. Since